In this After Effects tutorial, I'll show you how to create procedural animated textures based on standard effects, how to use them, how to make them loop, and how to save them as animation presets. Hi guys, my name is Manuel. There are two main effects used for creating textures, turbulent noise and fractal noise. If you ever wondered what the difference is, historically speaking, turbulent noise came first, fractal noise later, and they are exactly the same. Except for one thing, you can create loops with fractal noise. How? I'll show you later in this video. First of all, let's actually create an animated texture. My comp resolution is 1920 by 1080 pixels and is 5 seconds long. We add a new solid to our comp, color doesn't matter. Then let's use the effects and presets window to add fractal noise. We adjust some settings. Fractal type basic, noise type soft linear is fine. Contrast 120. Brightness minus 15. We made it darker altogether. We open transform and scale it up to 200%. By the way, if you uncheck uniform scaling, you can scale the width and height separately. Complexity, let's set it to 20, which adds more detail. Then we animate the evolution using an expression, time asterisk 200, which means the evolution is changing by 200 degrees per second. The bigger the number, the faster the animation. Okay, let's add another effect layer by duplicating the effect. This time we add even more contrast, around 440, brightness around 20. We reduce the complexity to 7. And let's slow it down. Time asterisk 50. Then we change the blending mode to multiply, so that the first layer shines through the white parts. Alright, still not that exciting. We clearly need more effects. So let's add posterize and reduce level to 3, which basically takes away all the color gradients. Then let's create some lines. Therefore, we add Venetian blinds. Set transition completion to 95%. Direction to 90 degrees. We want horizontal lines. Width around 30. That's like the distance between the lines. Awesome. Let's add a subtle movement to the lines. To do that, we add turbulent displace. Let's reduce the amount to 2, the size to 50. Complexity 1 is fine. Again, we animate the evolution, time asterisk 10. So pretty slow this time. Finally, let's reduce the frame rate. We add posterize time and set the frame rate to 8. Awesome, this is a unique lines texture with lots of details. I've done some work and put together 35 procedural animated textures for you. They're completely based on standard effects, easy to adjust, you can make them loop and use them as animation presets. Plus, there are 10 example scenes. Make sure to check out the link in the description. Let's take that lines texture we just created even further and make some sort of scribbled dots out of it. First of all, we need to change some of the settings. Fractal type, terrain, noise type, block. Let's hide these other effects for now to see what's going on. Now, let's quickly go through. Contrast 50, brightness 20, and let's slow the animation down. Evolution, time asterisk 50. And in transform, I think we should scale it up to around 900. The second fractal noise effect, contrast 140, brightness 30. And transform, we set scale to 300. Complexity 1. Let's double the speed, 100. Let's activate posterize again and set level to 15. Venetian blinds. Transition completion 60%. Width 8. Direction 45 degrees. To get dots, we simply duplicate the Venetian blinds effect and set the direction to 135 degrees. And that's how it looks like, zoomed in. Let's add the turbulent displace effect again. Amount 10. Size 20. Complexity 10. And we have a completely different texture. There's no right or wrong settings, it just takes some time to play around and find the right combination. Which is great, but how to use this texture? One way would be to colorize that grayscale solid using tritone. So let's add tritone and change the colors, the highlights, midtones, and shadows. And you basically have an animated background. The second option would be to use it as a bloomer mat. We add a background solid, then add a color gradient, for example, or whatever. Change the colors. And then we add a solid with the color we want the texture to have, like cyan, for example. Then we use the texture as luma mat for the cyan solid. You could invert the luma mat as well, of course. The third option is to use the blending modes here, like multiply to make it dark, or overlay, or add. I recommend to play around and explore. You might get some crazy results. How do we turn the texture into a loop? The secret is this checkbox. First of all, we delete all the expressions. Then in evolution options, we activate cycle evolution for the two fractal noise effects and the turbulent displace effect, which has the option as well. Then we add evolution keyframes at the beginning. At the end of our comp, we add the number of full 360-degree cycles the evolution moved. So let's change it to 3 for the two fractal noise effects and the turbulent displace effect to 1 to make this animation slower. And to be very accurate, we need to move these keyframes 1 frame further to the right. Otherwise, the first and last frame would be exactly the same. And we created a perfect loop. As this whole texture is one solid and based on effects, we can export it as animation preset. We select all the effects, go to animation, then to save animation preset. We choose a folder we want to save it to, this one. We name it, of course. Then After Effects warns us that we didn't save it in the right place. It needs to be inside the After Effects application folder. We open the folder and add the folder with our presets to the presets folder. Then restart After Effects. And here they are, ready to use. Make sure to check out the link in the description. On the left side, I've added some videos you might like. Subscribe to my channel on the right side and hit the bell, because you don't want to miss my next video. Thanks for watching this one. See you in the next one. Bye, guys.